I discovered Nixie tubes in 2011.
So it's been over 2 years since I published this video. It took us over 12 months to make it. I hired a freelance photographer, Honza, which helped me really a lot. I could focus on making actually the steps in the video, and he was preparing all the lighting setup, all the camera gear, everything. He was responsible also for the editing of the video. And it was more work than I initially expected, and I was all the time in doubt whether it's worth to spend all this effort just to make a video from the manufacturer, from our manufacturer, and share it with people. But soon after uploading the video to YouTube, we received several orders for our clocks, and with time it turned out that this platform and this video is the most important way how we can communicate with our customers and with all the audience. The video helped us to explain the labor which goes into manufacture of the Nixie tubes, and help us to explain all the time which was necessary to organize the manufacture and prepare all the machinery, the tools, and learn the skills necessary for the manufacturer. So in the end, it turned out that the video was probably the most important activity of what I did in the whole Nixie tube project, because it helped us to find the customers and to sell all our production. When I saw the interest of customers into our clocks, I got confident and I hired first employees. This helped me to focus on the development behind the technology, to focus more on building the machinery, researching the principles behind the Nixie tube, like the glass metal seals. This was the biggest challenge in all the manufacture. This is something which I had to spend so much time with, and something which still needs so much attention that it's sometimes incredible. With first employees, the effectivity went up because I could focus on this work which I mentioned, and the employees could do the manual work. So we were able to produce more Nixie tubes in the same time. Our fixed cost went lower. We went from red numbers to black numbers. At the beginning, it was just a dream of one reckless guy in Czech Republic dreaming about manufacturing Nixie tubes. I considered it quite easy because it was just it seemed to be like a piece of glass with few metal wires inside. I had no idea about how the Nixie tube actually work, like about these gases and all these sealing problems, all these glass and metal and these things. I had no idea about keeping the supplies going on the steady pace, about quality management and other things. After several years of very, very intensive work, I figured all these problems, and finally now we are running a small company. We have employees, they get their salary each month, they pay their mortgages, and we pay our rent here, we pay for the material, and we can manufacture. So this is great. This is really what makes me happy. It was worth it. There were many problems, many situations when I was afraid that maybe we will not make it, but we so far we are making it. That doesn't sound much optimistic, but it's really difficult to run it. So I'm never too confident about the manufacturer and about running the business, because it always can go wrong, and there are so many problems which can appear suddenly and just make so much troubles. There were also a lot of consequences with publishing the video and with getting a lot of orders. There were some negative things. It was a big jump. I was absolutely not ready for the amount of orders. Actually, it was not like hundreds or thousands of orders, but suddenly we had like 20 orders to fill, 20 clocks to make, and this was much more than we were making at this time, because if I remember well, at 2016 we were making something like 30 tubes per month. Yeah, something like this, 30 tubes per month, which is like five clocks, but it was not in the end 5 clocks, because there were some rejects. Some tube were like not good, because there was something bent inside, some welds were cracked, and you know this, so we had to reject them. 20 clocks would be our like 4 months production. So I had to find ways how to work faster, how to work more efficient, and this means that I had to focus completely only on the work, and I had to stop with writing blog. I was almost not adding photos to social networks and this, which was really disappointing for me, because I was, since the beginning, I was writing blog, I was sharing all the things behind, you know, like I enjoyed the process of learning and I wanted to share it with the audience. So this was kind of disappointing that I'm now suddenly closed in the workshop, and that I have to just work and work and work, and I have no time on documenting the work. So when I look back now on the photos from this time, there are almost no pictures, almost no videos, nothing. There's just this video, and then there is like 1 year silence. And this is what I want to change now. After these 2 years, since we published the video and started taking more and more orders, we finally reached some level of efficiency. We finally improved the speed in the manufacture. Also, it was about our employees to learn the work and get really good at it. Now I feel that it's time to start sharing more details from the work, from the project, how it works, because it's changing. We still do the same thing, we still manufacture just one tube, but the process and the development of the production is going quite fast. We improve things each week or each month, and there are a lot of things which can be covered and shared with you. So this is what I want to make now. I want to start taking videos. Whenever I do something or other people here do something, I want to document it. I want to share the videos on YouTube, and I want you to be part of the company here. So that's all for now. Thanks for watching, and I hope that I will see you at the next video. You know what? Let's take a short walk. So, this is my workshop. I fit it with some lights. There are now 3 1-kilowatt lights on the ceiling, so this gives enough light for the work and also for shooting the videos. It's not a super tidy, as you can see, it's quite a lot of mess here, but I hope that doesn't matter. On the video, it will look better. This is the getter cutter which I'm working on, so it will be soon published on the YouTube channel. I would like to also thank to all my customers, because without you I would not be able to make this work. It needs a lot of money. People need to be paid, the machinery need to be paid. There are a lot of expensive material going into the nixie tubes and the nixie cloak. So without you and without your purchases, I would not be able to do this job. So thank you very much, and I hope that you are enjoying your cloaks and your nixie tubes, and in case anything goes wrong, just contact me and we will solve everything out.